all we're talking about free Martin heifers. Free Martinism is a condition in which genetic sterility is caused in female offspring born to a male twin. It's common in cattle, but it's also present in pigs, sheep, goats, and buffalo.
Just a little lower.
90 to 97% of twins born in cattle result in this, but it's not an inherited trait. So it's caused by precocious anastomosis between the placental vascular systems of two fetuses, which means so precocious anastomosis is when early in fetal development there is connection between certain tissues. So like in this case, as you can see from this picture, these two fetuses share their vascular system, so which results in the masculinizing molecules reach the female twin and disrupt normal sexual differentiation. So this usually happens by day 40 of the pregnancy. It results in a sterile heifer, and the male is typically unaffected. So the environmental factors, hormonal regulation favoring double ovulation. So this can be caused by administering FSH, which is follicle-stimulating hormone, and it stimulates ovaries to release more than one egg at a time, which increases the chances that a cow will give birth to twins, or that two embryos will attach to the uterine lining. Assistive reproductive technology that kind of encompasses hormones such as FSH, but also anything that is increasing the number of ovulations that the cow is having. It could also be affected by age, priority, which is the number of births that a cow has had or has given, and then the season can also affect this, whether it's spring, winter, fall, summer. And this graphic just goes over the mechanism of FSH and how it increases ovulation. So some more environmental factors are management associated with can play a large role. So for example, high milk producing dairy cattle, they have an increased rate of twin calvings when there are hormonal and metabolic disturbances in the energy balance. So this is a graph of the energy balance over the course of lactation. So for example, maybe they're not getting enough feed energy, or their body energy stores are too low after they had given birth, and it causes hormonal imbalances as a result. Culling cows, embryo transfers when they're non-sexed can also cause this. So if you have sexed embryos, it's not such a big deal because usually they're sexed for females. But if they're non-sexed, then and you implant more than one, then there's a higher chance that you'll get a male and a female embryos or fetuses.
Yeah, it makes you talk just a little bit longer too.
So what happens? It causes genital tract defects, and the severity can kind of vary. It just depends on the case. Suppression and disorganization of the ovaries. The ovaries kind of tend to look more like testes, and they don't have germ cells, so they can't produce eggs. There's also an underdeveloped or reduced uterine horns. So like in this example, there is no uterine body or cervix. There's an anatomic discontinuity between the uterus and the vagina. So for example, the last one, there was no uterus, so there's no connection between the uterus and the vagina. There are rudimentary vesicular glands. There's an enlarged clitoris, small bulbar, and a male-like tuft of hair. In this graphic, this is a free Martin probe. It's also called a Ruin or Jovet probe, and basically you use it to test and see how deep the vagina is in the heifers.
Now you would do that like right shortly after birth, right?
Right.
Yeah.
So kind of the process how a female becomes free Martin. So it has a twin male in the womb. They share placental tissues, as you can see right here. Their vascular systems are connected. So it results in blood chimerism, which is when the blood stem cells are exchanged in early pregnancy. So the female ends up with male reproductive blood stem cells. So then what happens is valerian inhibiting substance goes to female, which causes this masculinized phenotype. So the valerian ducts develop into the uterus, that develop into the uterus, fallopian tubes, cervix, and the upper part of the vagina are inhibited if they share, before day 40, if they share blood stem cells. And that causes suppression of this development, and they don't form correctly or they don't form at all. It also results in hyperandrogenemia, which is the presence of too much testosterone or anti-malarian hormone, which is the same as malarian inhibiting substance in the female's bloodstream. So there is no treatment because there's no organs to perform a treatment on because they develop so poorly. The only cost that would happen were if a farmer were unaware of a free Martin heifer, just this sort of physiological instance, and would develop or would raise a female as a reproducing female rather than a market heifer. Typically, free Martins are raised as market heifers, so they develop like steers. So here, this is kind of what steer or market heifer should look like body condition wise, and then this is sort of the confirmation you want for a reproducing heifer.
So there is some lifelong
yes.
morphological changes
yes.
in the body, which I didn't realize. That was quite, that's quite stunning, really.
The female Martin, well, all Martin heifers are female,
right.
But free Martins will look more like males because of the mm-hmm. high levels of testosterone and the anti-malarian hormone.
Right.
So these are my sources. I mainly got most of it from the first one. This is a really excellent article if you guys are interested.
Mm-hmm.
Read this because it's pretty great.
Yeah, I've seen that article. Pretty good. All set?
Yep.
Okay.